Hey friends, so here we are gonna learn the most important topic of beta and gamma function, which is called as duplication formula. So guys, duplication formula is very important in solving multiple numericals of beta and gamma function. So here we'll see what is the duplication formula and how to derive that duplication formula. So on screen we have a duplication formula which says 2 raised to 2m minus 1 gamma m plus half is equal to root pi gamma 2m. So let's prove this duplication formula. Now here you can see all the gamma functions in the duplication formula, but this formula is derived from beta function. Now you must be thinking how. So let's start the derivation. So for that I will use the definition of beta function. So here you all know that integration from 0 to pi by 2 sine raised to p theta cos raised to q theta d theta is equal to 1 by 2 beta p plus 1 upon 2 comma q plus 1 upon 2. So this is the definition of beta function. Now from this definition we will derive this formula, and for that here in this definition we will substitute q by p. So here I'll say put q equal to p. So by doing this, here we will get integration 0 to pi by 2 sine raised to p theta. So q is p, so that will become cos raised to p theta d theta, and here we will get 1 by 2 beta p plus 1 upon 2 comma p plus 1 by 2. Now let's solve both the sides to get the duplication formula. So for this, here we have to apply the relationship between beta and gamma. So we all know that beta m comma n is given by gamma m gamma n upon gamma m plus n. So guys, here this value will work as m, this value we will consider as n, and then we'll apply this property. So on the right hand side we will get gamma p plus 1 by 2 gamma q plus 1 by 2, but here we have replaced that q with p. So there also we will get gamma p plus 1 by 2, and in the denominator addition of these two terms. So now we'll write down these values here. So here integration from 0 to pi by 2 sine raised to p theta cos raised to p theta d theta equals to 1 upon 2 gamma p plus 1 upon 2 upon 2p plus 2 upon 2. So we have used that property. Now this is nothing but 1 upon 2 gamma p plus 1 by 2 the whole square upon 2p upon 2 is p and 2 by 2 is 1. So we'll keep it as it is, and now we will solve the left hand side. So to solve the integral on the left hand side, here we have sine raised to p theta cos raised to p theta. What we'll do is here we will multiply and divide by 2 raised to p. So by doing that, here we will get p common, and 2 sin theta cos theta will become sin 2 theta. So here I'll say 1 upon 2 raised to p integration 0 to pi by 2. Here 2 raised to p sin raised to p theta into cos raised to p theta d theta. So I can take this p common, and 2 sin theta cos theta will become sin 2 theta. So here this integral I is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to p integration from 0 to pi upon 2 and this is sine raised to p 2 theta d theta. And for time being, I'll call this as equation number 1. So once we'll solve this integration, then we'll put that value in equation number 1 and then we'll prove the duplication formula. Now the question is how to solve this integration. So here we have sine raised to p 2 theta, and to solve this integration we will use the integration by substitution method, and for that we will put this 2 theta equals to t. So here I'll say put 2 theta equal to t, so that will give d theta as dt upon 2. Also the limits will change, so for theta it is from 0 to pi upon 2. Now let's observe it for t. So when theta is 0, this t will be 0, but when theta is pi upon 2, t will be pi. So limit is changing from 0 to pi. So let's substitute everything over there. So here we will get I equal to 1 upon 2 raised to p integration from 0 to pi. Here we will get sine raised to p into t, and d theta is dt upon 2. So sine raised to p into t and dt upon 2. Now here 1 upon 2 raised to p as it is, I can take 1 upon 2 outside, and here we will get 0 to pi sine raised to p t dt. Now the question is how to solve this integral. So still we got the same trigonometric term, only the angle is t now. So most of the student here, they use the beta function, the definition of beta function. But guys, remember that for the definition of beta function, we should have the limit from 0 to pi by 2 over here. Then only we can apply the definition of beta function. So here we cannot apply the beta function, but yes, if we apply the properties of definite integral over here, then we can convert it in a form where we'll get the limit from 0 to pi by 2, and then we can apply the definition of beta function. So which property of definite integral will be used here? So for that, I'll tell you the property. So you all know that integration from 0 to 2a f of x dx is equal to 2 times integration from 0 to a f of x dx. So this property is true if the condition is f of 2a minus x must be equal to f of x. So guys, let's see here. Here if I compare this left hand side with this integration, then my 2a will be pi. Now f of x is sine raised to pt, so let's check. So I have sine t, in that I'll put 2a minus x, that is sine of, here 2a is pi, so pi minus x, but in my case it is t, so pi minus t. And guys, sine of pi minus t is also sine t. So it means the value of f of x is equal to f of 2a minus x. So I can definitely apply this property. So by using this property, here we will get 1 upon 2 raised to p as it is, 1 by 2 as it is, and this will become 2 times integration 0 to pi upon 2 sine raised to pt dt. Now here 2 and 2 is cancelled, and see here we got the limit from 0 to pi by 2, and now I can apply the definition of beta function. So here this is the definition of beta function. So by the definition, if we compare, then here the value of this p is p, the value of q is 0 because cos term is absent, so we can consider it as cos raised to 0 theta. So q is 0, so this will become 1 upon 2 beta p plus 1 by 2 comma Q is 0, so only 1 upon 2. So here I'll say it is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to P into 1 upon 2 beta P plus 1 upon 2 comma 1 upon 2. Now let's solve this. So here we will get 1 upon 2 raised to P into 1 by 2. And to solve this, here I'll apply the property, which is the relationship between beta and gamma. So this is m comma n is gamma n upon gamma m plus n. So this will become gamma p plus 1 upon 2, then gamma half, and this is p upon 2, then 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 2 will become 1. So here we got this value for the integral I. Now what we'll do, we will substitute this value of I in equation number 1. So guys, here you must be remember that I have kept equation number 1 and I had solved this left hand side. Now whatever value that we got, we'll put it over here. So this equation 1 will become, here I'll say, from equation number 1, the left hand side is 1 upon 2 raised to p into 1 by 2 into gamma p plus 1 upon 2 into gamma half upon gamma p by 2 plus 1 equal to, the right hand side is this, so which is 1 upon 2 gamma p plus 1 by 2 the whole square upon gamma p plus 1. Now we will cancel the terms which are same, so I can cancel this 1 upon 2 with 1 upon 2, then gamma p plus 1 by 2 with one term of gamma p plus 1 by 2, and the remaining term are like this. So 1 upon 2 raised to p, gamma half is root pi upon, this is gamma p by 2 plus 1. Next, here we got gamma p plus 1 upon 2 upon gamma p plus 1. Now guys, from here we have to derive the duplication formula. So see here, this is the duplication formula where the power of 2 must be 2m minus 1. And here we got the power of 2 as p. So it means we have to substitute p as 2m minus 1. So here I'll say, put p equal to 2m minus 1. So this will give us, when 1 will go there, that will become p plus 1 upon 2. So here I'll say that is m is equal to p plus 1 upon 2. So see here, we got the substitution for this p as well as for this p plus 1 by 2. So this will become 1 upon 2 raised to 2m minus 1, then root pi upon, now here p is 2m minus 1, so here I'll say inside the gamma 2m minus 1 upon 2 plus 1. Next is equal to, this will become m, so gamma m upon, this is p is 2m minus 1, so here we will get 2m minus 1 plus 1, that is only 2m. Now here we'll solve this term from the denominator, and I'll send this 2 raised to 2m minus 1 on the other side, so that will become root pi upon, and here is equal to 2 raised to 2m minus 1 gamma m upon gamma 2m. So now here 2m upon 2 will give us m, so inside the gamma that is m, Next, minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So minus half plus 1 is positive half. So here I'll say plus half. Now we'll rewrite the terms. I'll send this gamma 2m on left hand side and this gamma m plus half on right hand side. So therefore here we'll get root pi by gamma 2m into gamma 2m is equal to 2 raised to 2m minus 1 gamma m plus half. And guys, if you see, then this is nothing but our duplication formula where we have started. So this is the formula which we have proved here by using the properties and the definition of gamma and beta function. So if you like this video and if you want to learn more concepts and numericals of engineering mathematics, then log into ekeeda.com today itself and you can learn all the concepts of mathematical engineering over there. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter to get the latest updates about the engineering mathematics. Thank you. See you in the next video.